Hello students, hope you all are well. So I'm going to take a chapter from our corporate law, that is director. I've given a question of director in our for our assignments also. So before going to discuss about their rights and duties, let us first know about directors. Now directors means a director appointed by the board of directors to look after the corporate affairs of the company, and they are appointed unanimously through votes, and they are responsible for directing, governing, controlling policy or management of the company. So traditionally we know about when we use the word director, like terminologies comes to our mind that are like managing director, full-time director, general manager and all. But after 2013 amendment made in Companies Act, some new concepts were also introduced. So we'll be discussing on those concepts in our today's class itself. So before that, let us know about some new terminologies introducing our Companies Act 13, that is residential directors, women directors, shadow directors, nominee directors, and apart from this, the executive directors are obviously there, and managing directors are also there. So first we will be discussing on the residential directors. Actually, residential directors are nothing but the directors. They are they have to stay for 182 days in the previous calendar year, and they should be resident of India, and they have to play the role of directors. They are like full-time directors. They have every they can take part in every matters, crucial matters of the company, like in policy making, decision making and all. And they are residential directors because they the thing is that 182 days have to stay in India without any break in the previous calendar year. And apart from this, another topic is women director. Women directors are actually they are made compulsory, ordered by the central government to have compulsory directors, women directors, for those companies who are number one should be they are listed company, number two they any public company having turnover of rupees 300 crore or more and paid up capital of rupees 100 crore or more. So from this particular introduction, that is compulsory order made by Companies Act, we can nowadays see many directors in leading companies in oil sector, in banking sector, as women directors, and they are doing well also. Now next one is shadow directors. They are not officially appointed by the board, but he or she gives such advice to the directors because of his professional competencies or capacities. So they are shadow directors because they are keeping a veil, kind of veil. Veil means burqa or parda, because they are not coming in front of the public as directors, but they are as they are not officially appointed, so we can call them as shadow directors. Then again, nominee directors. These nominee directors are the directors who are appointed by banks or central government. Because in some cases those non-executive directors may not be playing efficient enough to manage the company or look after the affairs of the company. Because in our BOED class also, when we are talking about the topic venture capital, there also I spoke about this thing, because when the bank and other financial institutions invest huge amount in a public particular company, appoint one director nominate one director also to look after the affairs of that particular newly venture company, newly introduced venture company, because they are have invested in the capital as venture capital. So to keep safe of their money, they sometimes appoint or nominate some higher level employee from the bank or any financial institutions to like act as a director of that particular company. So they are nominee directors. And apart from this, the private limited companies, they should have executive directors who have to work full time. They have to work full time. They have to like have some additional responsibility to look after the company, the private limited company. And apart from that, managing directors are also there who have full responsibility to manage the company. So these are the traditional concept, traditional terminologies, because obviously these directors are also there, but these 13 amendments, these shadow directors, women directors, residential directors, nominee directors, these concepts have been introduced. Now let us one more thing I want to say about the managing director. Managing directors have substantial ability to take decisions, to manage and direct other members of the company. And a public company or subsidiary of a public company with share capital of more than 5 crores or more must have a managing director. This is one important concept, because for managing these public companies or subsidiary of a public company with share capital more than 5 crores or more must have a managing director. And he has to take decision to manage the affairs of the company. And apart from this, he has to also direct other members. And another thing is that independent director, they do not have any direct relationship with the company, but they are independently appointed. And one new thing is coming in this Companies Act is that small shareholder director. And now, who are these directors? Small shareholder directors. So companies can also appoint a single director in a listed company by issuing notice to at least 1,000 shareholders or 1/10 of the share, and they have to approve for appointment of these small shareholder directors. And this is a single director. Because why they are small shareholder directors? Because their investment is substantially low in that particular company, but from them also they can appoint, they can have the chance to speak on the corporate affairs of the company. And they are appointed by issuing notice to at least 1,000 shareholders or 1/10 of the shareholders, and after their approval only small shareholder directors can be appointed. Then again, alternate directors. When a director is remain absent for more than 3 months, then these alternate directors can be appointed. And alternate directors has to play the role of the it's kind of like proxy director, but that particular word is not used in Companies Act, but I am saying only in absence of that particular other director who remain absent for more than 3 months, these alternate directors have to be appointed, and they have every right and duties as general director, means ordinary director, or in whose place this director is appointed. And this assignment, I have given one question about the rights and duties of directors. I don't know why students are so much confused about writing about the rights of directors, because without rights, no director can exercise any power, or no director can fulfill any duties. So rights are again divided into two categories. One is individual rights, another one is collective rights. And individual, these rights are actually legally enforceable rights. Enforceable rights or of the directors. Legally enforceable means the Companies Act itself has enforced the rights. And as we all know, these directors are appointed as per the provisions of Article of Association. So as per the provisions also, they are enjoying some rights. So I have already mentioned about the rights into two categories. One is individual rights, another one is collective rights. So individual rights are right to inspect books of account, right to receive notice of board meeting, right to receive draft circular resolutions, right to receive sitting fees for company meetings, right to be heard at general meeting, right to inspect minutes of board meeting, and right to participate and vote at the general meeting or any meeting of the company, right to appoint, right to ask for appointment of alternate directors, and right to claim for travel and stay or other expenses from the company. So these are the general, like individual rights and collective rights. There are right to elect chairman, right to refuse transfer of shares, right to take part in appointment of managing director, right to recommend for dividend, and right to approve investment. So these are the rights, collective rights enjoyed by the directors. So in my next class, I'll be discussing on the duties and responsibilities of directors. So thank you for today. Have a nice day.